हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन माय फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन टू स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड सम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स। इन द प्रीवियस थ्री क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, फंक्शंस एंड लिमिटेशंस ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, स्कोप ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड ऑल्सो वी स्टडीड some basic concepts on statistics. Today we are going to study some more basic concepts on introduction to statistics and some basic concepts. Today's first concept is quantitative data. Numerically expressed data are called quantitative data, means the data which is expressed in terms of numbers are called as quantitative data. Then we have qualitative data. The data which are not numerically expressed are called qualitative data. It means the data which is not possible to express in terms of numbers are called as qualitative data. Also, in the previous classes we studied what is meant by qualitative characteristics and quantitative characteristics. Then the next concept is types of scales of measurements. There are two types of scales of measurements, that is nominal scale and second is ordinal scale. Now let's see what is meant by nominal scale. A number assigned for every unit for identification of different categories is called nominal scale. A number assigned for every unit for identification of different categories is called nominal scale. For example, roll numbers assigned to students of a college, or another example is numbers assigned to the cricket players, or the numbers assigned to hockey players, or the numbers assigned to the football players, etc. These numbers are assigned simply as a identification or symbols, and that is nothing but nominal scale. Then next concept is ordinal scale. The numbers are assigned to observations and that can be arranged in ascending or descending order is called ordinal scale. The numbers are assigned to observations and that can be arranged in ascending, means increasing, or descending, means decreasing order is called ordinal scale. For example, ranks given to the students according to their performance. Or another example, in a shop, three varieties of rice are assigned the numbers 1, 2, 3 according to their quality. For example, number 1 is assigned for the best quality, second is moderate quality, third is low quality, or vice versa. And this is nothing but ordinal scale. So these all definitions we studied in introduction to statistics and some basic concepts. Now let's see what are the different questions they may ask in the exams on this introduction to statistics and some basic concepts. As I told, this unit will come in the exam for 8 marks. You will get 1 marks one question, then 2 marks one question, and 5 marks one question on this introduction to statistics and some basic concepts. So whatever the previous 3 videos you have seen or today's video, from that you are searching the answers for these following questions. The first question is, what are the two senses in which the term statistics is generally used? So there are two senses, that is plural sense and singular sense. Then second question is, distinguish between statistics as numerical data and statistics as statistical methods. With an example, you can search these answers in the previous videos. Then the third question is, state Professor Horace Sechrist's definition of statistics. So this definition we studied under the banner of definition of statistics in plural sense. Then the fourth question is, mention the characteristics of statistics. Now this question is very important. In the exam they may ask this question for 1 mark or for 2 marks, or it may come for 5 marks. If they ask for 1 mark, then you have to write one characteristic of statistics. For 2 marks you need to write 2 characteristics, and for 5 marks you need to write at least five characteristics of statistics. Then the next question is, state A.L. Bowlby's and Crockston and Cowden's definition of statistics. So these definitions we studied in the heading definitions of statistics in singular sense. So you can write these 2 definitions. Then the next question is, what are the branches of statistics? So we studied that there are 2 branches of statistics, that is statistical methods and applied statistics. Then the next question, question number 7, mention any 2 branches of applied statistics. So we have seen that there are different branches of applied statistics, that is statistics in biology called biostatistics, or statistics in economics, econometrics, and so on. You need to write the 2 branches of applied statistics. Then the next question, question number 8, what are the functions of statistics? Again this question is very important. They may ask this question for 1 mark or 2 mark or 5 mark. As I told, if they ask for 1 mark, you need to write 1 function of statistics. If they ask for 2 marks, then you need to write 2 functions of statistics. And if they ask for 5 marks, then at least 5 functions of statistics you have to write. Then question number 9, what are the limitations of statistics? This is also important, because again here they will ask for 1 mark or 2 mark or 5 mark. So accordingly you need to write the limitations of statistics, which we already studied in the previous videos. Then in some basic concept, first question is, define population. We have already studied that the totality of units under consideration is called population. That definition you need to write here. Then define sample. Different 3 definitions we studied for sample. Anyone you remember and write for the sample. We have seen that a finite subset of a population is called sample, or a part of a population is called sample, or the representative units of a population is called sample. Any one definition you remember and write for this question. Then next question is, define quantitative and qualitative characteristics with an example. We have seen that the characteristics which are numerically measurable are called as quantitative characteristics. For example, height, weight, number of students, etc. And we have seen that another definition, the characteristics which are not numerically measurable are called as qualitative characteristics. For example, taste, beauty, religion, etc. So you can write easily the answer for this question. Then define variable. We already studied that the quantitative characteristics which changes or varies from unit to unit is called variable. For example, height, weight, etc. Then the next question is, define attribute. Here the qualitative characteristics which changes or varies from unit to unit is called as an attribute. For example, the taste, beauty, etc. Then the next question is, define discrete variable and give an example of discrete variable. We have studied the definition of variable, and we know that there are two types of variable, that is discrete variable and continuous variable. Here discrete variable is number of students, number of benches, etc., which are discrete, means 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay, then the next question is define continuous variable with and give its example. So continuous variable is a variable which takes all the possible values within a given range is called as continuous variable. For example, height of the students, weight of the students, etc. These are the examples of continuous variable. The next question is write the difference between variable and attribute. Based upon the definitions of variable and attribute and their examples, you can easily write the difference between variable and attribute. And the last question is write the difference between discrete variable and continuous variable. Just we discuss about discrete variable and continuous variable with its examples. Based upon that, you can easily write the difference between discrete variable and continuous variable. So you need to write all these questions and answers in the same book, whichever I told to make the book for statistics. In that book, you can write all these answers. With this, we have completed the unit number 1, a small unit, that is introduction to statistics and some basic concepts. Thank you.